Hello and welcome back to Chatterbox. I'm Jen, your host, resident slow coffee drinker and purveyor of written wisdom and chat. And I just wanted to do a quick update on a few things that have been happening over the last week or so since the previous Chatterbox video. And this has been delayed somewhat by my yet again losing my memory card. It's here somewhere, but rather than turn the place inside out looking for it, I bought some more. So this time I bought two, and I think I'm going to leave the spare in the packet to make it a bit easier to find when I inevitably lose the one that's in the camera now. So there should now be two or three lost memory cards poking around somewhere. I've got a horrible feeling they keep falling in my bin bag because it's at the side of the bench here, but anyway. So yeah, here I am, a little late, but here nonetheless. Now, I've had a most excellent care package sent through by Ed Sutton from Premium Hobbies. Some of you may recall that I bought some masking circles and bits and bobs sanders, actually these beautiful Infini sanders. I've been using them, but I'm so anal that I've been using the backs so they still look nice in the holder here. And the mask circles, and I paid money for those, but I noted in the little message to seller thing that I'd be featuring them on YouTube, and in due course Ed got in touch and thanked me for mentioning them on YouTube, and offered to send me some gear, and this is what they have sent. It's some more of these little holderifiers. So got the top notch ones here that I got from them, and now we've got the Premium Hobbies version. So as I said in the last issue or review of these things, I don't feel that's quite tight. I've never actually knocked one of these over, so I feel like these are a little bit of a solution searching for a problem. But I'm absolutely sold, to be honest, now with these, because I've knocked these things and things like it over more times than I care to remember, and this just absolutely stops that. And I have found myself using these circular ones quite a lot. But anyway, Premium Hobbies have sent me their versions through. They're also 3D printed. This one is the only one that's this colour. It's in this pale speckly grey, which to me is very reminiscent of the paint they used to put on the walls in 1980s public toilets here in England, and those of you who are as vintage as me may well remember the said paint. So this is a triple Tamiya one. You know, you can also use it for the wonderful Tamiya washes. If you're doing a model and you want to use a couple of colours, stick your Tamiya washes in there, because you don't want to knock a bottle of wash over on your desk. Trust me, I've done it. So that's a triple Tamiya, and this is on the site for £5.50, which is actually slightly cheaper than the top notch. But currently, this particular triple Tamiya version is on offer for £3.50, which is a bargain. So that's that one. Then there's the obligatory Mister version, because the Mister jars are just slightly bigger than the Tamiya ones, so they don't fit the Tamiya holder, whereas the Tamiya can quite happily go in the Mister holder. The double Mister, £4.95. And here we've got a paint one. So Premium Hobbies do two versions of this one for the Mister paint. This version fits the newer Mister paint, which is now in a plastic bottle. It's not a very squidgy plastic bottle, it's quite a hard plastic, but it's a plastic bottle now instead of a glass one. So this version caters for that, and they do a separate version which will hold the older glass ones, which are a little bit bigger. Same amount of paint inside, just a slightly bigger bottle, and it's made of glass rather than plastic. So they do a separate holder that fits that. And the last one they've sent, these are £7.95. And again, these are really easy to knock over. Really easy. So worthwhile, I think. And the last one is the set and sole holder, microscale. But this one's pretty neat in that it's got other slots on it to fit other tools in. Like your tweezers, I don't think that's a good idea. I'd stab myself for days if I did that. But you can fit other things, paint brushes and little bits and bobs in there. And what I particularly like about this one is when you've got your lid off, you can just pop it in there, out of the way, nice and safe. And they've even printed set and sole into the side there so that you can put the right lid back onto the right bottle when you're done. Now, I don't currently own any set and sole, but I am going to be doing a massive foiling project very, very soon. And I'll stick my metal foil glue in here instead. This one is £6.50, which I think is really, really good because that's a nice little thing that if you, like me, sometimes have to travel with your modelling, you can chuck that in the toolbox and you can have a little mobile organiser for just a few little bits and pieces, which is all you take with you when you're travelling around anyway, isn't it? So that's those. Yeah, all of them really nice. And I think as much as arguably they're not really necessary, potentially, depending on how clumsy you are, they do lend a sort of, I'm going to say it, premium feel to the workbench. Please excuse the pun. It's a bit like the difference between having your spanners just laid in your toolbox drawer or having your spanners in a spanner holder in your toolbox drawer, or having your toolbox with the layer of foam with the cutouts for each spanner. It's just, it's a small difference, but it's one that a certain type of mindset will appreciate, and I do think a lot of modellers have that certain type of mindset. Plus, who doesn't like buying tools? Okay, so that's those. Excuse me. And they also sent me a selection of Mr. Paints. Now, Mr. Paints are a lacquer paint, an acrylic lacquer, pre-thinned, ready to airbrush. And I really, really like Mr. Paint. Here's a little sample of what this yellow looks like when it's on something. You can see, beautifully smooth and a little bit shiny, lovely surface. Arguably pretty much ready for deckling, actually, if you were going to put any on a on the other bit of a propeller. But it's really, really lovely paint. It's very, very easy to use. It's very, very forgiving. Usually covers it very, very well. It's just all round pleasant to use. And my only issue with it in the past has been that it's so difficult to get hold of at times. Now, I do know that Premium Hobbies have just had a restock, so it should be that the majority of the colours are pretty much in stock at the minute. And they're also running an offer, I see on the website here. Get a free Tamiya cement holder with all orders over £40. If you spend more than £40, you get one of these little holders to have a try of. Might be worth a look. MRP have got the half glass paints out as well. If you're building any of the one of the myriad of F35 kits that seems to be out coming out at the minute. So yeah, they've sent me a good selection of these. These are all RAF colours because I do find myself modelling a lot of English subjects, probably not surprisingly, but they have also sent a selection of clear, a matte, a gloss, a semi-gloss and a semi-matte. I'll be interested to see what the difference is between semi-gloss and semi-matte, but I suspect semi-matte will probably be slightly less shiny than semi-gloss, but we'll have a test. Now, Ed did not ask me to do a review of the Mr. Paints or anything like that, but I will. And I'm thinking maybe I'll do a sort of back-to-back comparison type review with the SMS, which is the same kind of deal. It's an acrylic lacquer, also sold in 30ml jars for a similar price per jar. I think it'd be an interesting comparison because they categorically are not the exact same product because these are made in Australia and Mr. Paints are made in Europe. So it'll be interesting. Whoops, I just dropped that. So let me know in the comments what you think, whether you'd rather see SMS and Mr. Paint reviewed separately or whether you'd rather see them done in tandem and actually directly compared. And I'll take that on board and do whatever seems right. I've also sent through the little catalogue. I think you probably get that in every order, but this provides a quick overview of some of the stuff Premium Hobbies do. And I think they've named themselves well because most of the accessories that they have are Japanese high-end stuff. But the prices aren't ridiculous, and they're also a stockist of Mr. Hobby products. And this time they've also sent a large size Mr. Paint colour catalogue, which is nice. They're very, very happy with that, and I do want to say a huge thank you to the guys at Premium Hobbies for sending that stuff over. I do really appreciate it. It's always nice to be recognised like that. In a quick reference back, just to finish to Nippergate, I have been using the God Hands, and they are very, very nice. They have a much sturdier feel to them than the Tamiya nippers, which is probably mostly because of the bigger grips, but the blades are slightly thicker and chunkier as well. There is very slightly less finesse because of the fact that the blade is that little bit wider, but overall I'm getting on really well with these so far, so quite happy with them. So that is it for this week's Chatterbox. So please let me know in the comments if you've got any opinion at all, if you'd rather see the Mr. Paint and SMS separately, or if I should do some kind of competition style test, give them marks and see what wins. And I'll try and sort that out for you. Do have a quick look at Premium Hobbies if you fancy any of this stuff. As I say, these are on sale at the moment for just £3.50, and you get a free one if you spend over £40. If you don't think you fancy these, don't forget that I've got the discount code on the Top Notch website, 20% off there if you use the discount code, and I'll reproduce that below as well. So again, thanks very much to Premium Hobbies for that. And if you got to the end, thanks for watching. So with all that said, it only remains for me to say, look after yourselves, look after each other, and Genesis out.